Resident Evil 4 is one of the most important and one of the most talked-to-death games of all time. It reinvented its own franchise, defined an entire console generation, and its inspiration can still be seen in action games today. And it's a blast to play. All the different scenarios, diverse level design, simple core mechanics, the fast and satisfying gameplay loop, the lack of anything superfluous, it makes the game a tight and fun experience, and endlessly replayable in an arcadey way. The story is utterly insane. The heroes are all one-liner shooting corn factories, the villains are hilarious caricatures with overly complicated plans, half the stuff in the plot makes absolutely no sense, and happens just because. It's a crazy amalgamation of both action and horror movie clichés, basically a parody of itself. But at the same time, it's a super enjoyable ride, if you are willing to laugh with it, or at it, depending on the situation. It's one of my favorite games of all time, and one of the best ever made. It makes sense that the game is ported to nearly every console imaginable. It's one of those quintessential gaming experiences. Which brings us to the latest iteration of RE4. The game recently got a VR version, which is whatever, I don't really care. I personally have never been too interested in VR games. What I do care about, however, is the erasure of history by fucked in the head Puritans. The fresh release of RE4 has had several lines of dialogue censored, removed, erased, in order to make the game more palatable for, quote, a modern audience. More specifically, any scene that even hints at the fact that the characters in the game are indeed heterosexual, and would maybe like to express that fact with another character sometime, flirting, I'm talking about flirting, are considered far too suggestive for modern times. Apparently, in this game, where you can roundhouse kick a person to the face so hard that their head explodes like a watermelon, any mention of male-female relations is just far too grotesque to leave in. Now I could just rant and rave and call the people in charge what they are, a bunch of castrated weasels, but someone else has no doubt already done that. I would like to take things a step deeper. Make a quick analysis of exactly what we have lost, what kind of scandalous text was removed, and how does the censored content affect the game's narrative. Not much else to it, so let's get to it. The first altered scene is right at the start of the game. Leon gets a call from his agency, and we get introduced to his backup slash guide slash handler person, the lovely Ingrid Hannigan. Here's the original scene.
Leon, I hope you can hear me. I'm Ingrid Hannigan. I'll be your support on this mission.
Loud and clear. Somehow I thought you'd be a little older. So the subject's name's Ashley Graham, right?
That's right.
And here's the new altered version.
Leon, I hope you can hear me. I'm Ingrid Hannigan. I'll be your support on this mission.
Loud and clear. So the subject's name's Ashley Graham, right?
So here we have an example of the most innocent, harmless, milquetoast flirting in existence. How to tell a lady she looks pretty without telling them she looks pretty. The way Leon goes about it is rather unsubtle and doofy, but that's part of his character. In any situation, Leon always speaks his mind freely, which sometimes ends up as cool one-liners, and other times as sweet, sweet cringe.
Where's everyone going? Bingo?
Yes. Finger licking good.
There's really nothing offensive here. Just a somewhat dorky guy being who he is. And as for Hannigan, there's some subtle characterization to be read from the scene. When complimented on her looks, she brushes it off, like it's nothing, and keeps focus on the matter at hand. She's a professional through and through. She even jabs at Leon, reminding him to be on his best behavior, since the person they are about to rescue is the president's daughter. The random jab makes no sense without Leon placing a precedent for potential awkwardness with his flirting. The next altered scene is a little ways into the game, at the start of chapter 2. Leon loses consciousness due to the Plaga parasite. When he finally comes 2 hours later, Hannigan makes contact, understandably worried about him. Here's the original scene.
Leon, it's been 6 hours since our last transmission. I was starting to get worried.
Don't you mean lonely? Anyway, I started to feel dizzy, and then I guess I must have lost consciousness.
Lost consciousness?
And here's the altered one.
Leon, it's been 6 hours since our last transmission. I was starting to get worried.
I started to feel dizzy, and then I guess I must have lost consciousness.
Again, a quick, tiny, innocent, joking remark. Leon is at once keeping up his flirtatious banter with Hannigan and decompressing the situation. All the events thus far have been obviously stressful, but there's still a long way to go. Leon is the type of person who doesn't wish to be coddled, not when there's work to be done, so he deflects Hannigan's worry by using humor. There's nothing to be offended by. These changes are truly annoying, since they weaken the characterization of both Leon and Hannigan. Hannigan especially, since she is in the game for so little, and the only showcase of character she gets is through her interactions with Leon. For what little there is, the original version of the game paints them as a pair of co-workers with some truly cute chemistry. It's not just Leon making banter and poking fun at the other. Hannigan is just as capable of making sly remarks.
Hannigan, it's Leon. The door's locked. I can't get in.
Didn't they teach you how to pick locks at the academy?
Yeah. There's some sort of indentation, like something might fit inside.
Well, there's no use standing around. Leon, you have to find some way or something to get inside.
The sign of a healthy relationship is when two people are able to dish out and take a joke, and then go on as friends. Next up, we got a whopper of a scene. A real spicy meatball. Leon and Ashley seek refuge from the angry Puritan mob inside a conveniently placed cabin and run into Louis Serra. Being the sleazy rogue type character that he is, Louis has something to say about Ashley's figure. Let's have a look. Here's the original one.
Small world, eh? Well, I see that the president's equipped his daughter with ballistics, too.
How rude! And I don't believe there's any relevance with my figure and my standing. Who are you?
Oh, excuse me, Your Highness.
And here's the new one.
Small world, eh?
Who are you?
Oh, excuse me, Your Highness.
So out of all of the changes, I actually hate this one the most. The remark is utterly out of the blue, completely uncalled for, and sexist. No question about that. However, that is exactly the goddamn point. Louis is being a dick. That's his character. He's already shown to be selfish and cowardly earlier in the game. His research, his hubris, is part of the reason why everything is currently going to shit with Las Plagas and Los Illuminados. He is less than an ideal person. And yet, at the same time, he's wrought with guilt. He wants to put an end to the chaos he helped cause. And against all odds, in the end, he does everything in his power to help out Leon and Ashley. It's sickening to think that nuance and redemption are concepts far too complex for today's world. How the hell are we supposed to tell meaningful stories if we aren't allowed to depict people with actual flaws? And not to worry, if you are one of those people who see any offense towards women as deserving of the death penalty, then Resi Force got you covered. Louis ends up dying horribly in the end. That should satiate the bloodlust of any Twitter mob. That's one half, the other half is Ashley. Now I know there's a group of people who just absolutely loathe Ashley. She's annoying, she gets in the way, she ruins the game, that kind of thing. I for one have never minded her. Her AI is simplistic and extremely predictable, which is great. She moves when I tell her to, she stops when I tell her to, she keeps close, she ducks out of the way of gunfire, she never runs off and gets herself killed. Speaking purely gameplay-wise, far as I'm concerned, Ashley is a prime example of how to do an escort mission right. As for her personality, she acts exactly as a sheltered girl would act in a stressful situation like this. Aside from that, she has a steadfast heart deep down. Although she ain't a fighter, when push comes to shove, she always musters her courage and pulls her weight by helping Leon with whatever he needs. She's never completely paralyzed by fear. I think that's commendable, all things considered. The altered scene is actually one of Ashley's best moments, and it's a crime against storytelling and proper characterization to cast it aside like this. Think for a moment what is actually happening in the scene. Ashley is faced by a sexist remark, and what does she do? She dismantles the dumbass and tells him off, no more, no less.
How rude! And I don't believe there's any relevance with my figure and my standing. Who are you?
Confident, relatively calm, like a person who knows their own worth. She doesn't foam and rage excessively, she responds exactly as any emotionally stable human being ought to. I can't say for anyone else, but for me that sounds awfully lot like a strong female character. But as time goes on, that designation has become more and more confused, so the fuck do I know, right? Now the final altered scene is right at the end of the game. Leon and Ashley ride out into the sunset at the end of a job well done. After all the trials and tribulations, all the dangers, the countless near-death experiences, after this life-altering experience is finally over, it would be odd if two people facing all that side by side hadn't grown close together in some extent. Especially if one of them happened to be a relatively young and naive lady. As such, Ashley has a small proposition for Leon. Let's have a look. Here's the original one.
Let's go home.
Sounds like a great idea. Mission accomplished. Right, Leon?
Not quite. I still have to get you home safe.
So, after you take me back to my place, how about we do some, overtime?
Sorry.
Somehow I knew you'd say that, but it doesn't hurt to ask, you know? So, who was that woman anyway?
Why do you ask?
Come on, tell me.
She's like a part of me I can't let go. Let's leave it at that.
And here's the altered version.
Mission accomplished, right, Leon?
Not quite. I still have to get you home safe.
So, who was that woman anyway?
Why do you ask?
Come on, tell me.
So Ashley would like to be more than friends with Leon. I can't exactly blame her. The guy is dependable, kind, strong, funny, and I guess handsome if you're into the whole grizzled babyface look. And props for being direct, just coming out and speaking your mind. People should be more honest about their affections, even if they get shot down in the end. Human relations would be so much easier to manage if we all were more sincere with one another. Now obviously Leon turns Ashley down, and the fact that he does so informs his character quite a bit. Even though we've seen his flirtatious streak with Hunnigan, he isn't the type of guy who just chases any tail coming his way. Maybe Ashley isn't his type? She is rather young. Maybe he thinks taking advantage of her wouldn't be proper? Maybe he doesn't want to complicate his relationship with his new friend? It could be one of these, it could be a combination of all of them. Whatever the case, Leon is shown to be a decent guy. That was the final altered scene of the game. However, there's still one more change. The post-credit scene where Leon and Hunnigan chat was apparently so spicy that Capcom just decided, fuck it, let's just axe the whole thing. Let's check it out.
Hunnigan, is that you?
Finally, the line's jack-free.
Hey, Hunnigan, no glasses.
Forget the glasses. What's the status of the mission?
I've rescued the subject. We're returning home.
You did it, Leon.
Thanks. You know, you're kind of cute without those glasses. Give me your number when I get back.
May I remind you that you're still on duty?
Story of my life.
Once again, the scene is perfectly harmless flirting. It's endearing. It's cute. Leon is doing his whole action hero pseudo James Bond charm thing to his very own Moneypenny, only to get shot down. After facing hordes of monsters, fighting off an entire mad cult, escaping who knows how many death traps, brushing with a femme fatale, saving the day, saving the girl, after acing every hurdle thrown his way, he still can't score a date with the lady he likes. Story of my life. That's the fucking joke! It's supposed to be the final punchline of the game, and now it's just gone. Good job, Capcom. Good job. Real slow clap moment right there. After all is said and done, the decision to censor dialogue in Resident Evil 4 is utterly absurd. Every cut line of dialogue is perfectly harmless. Worse, they inform the characters. And by removing them, the game's narrative is made less than it previously was. The story of the game is bonkers. But I think one thing it did exceedingly well is making all the characters memorable and distinct. A small piece of writing advice to anyone out there. The secret behind effective dialogue, not necessarily good, but effective, is to make it so that every line of dialogue does either of two things. Every line should either progress the story or reveal something about the characters. Dialogue is the soul of a story. Especially a character-centric tale. Much of the character and charm of Resi 4 cast is still intact in the newest version of the game, but parts of it have been lost. Let's make no mistake about that. History is being rewritten, effective art is being watered down. All in the name of progressive agenda. And you know what's the most embarrassing part in all this? It's all made to appease people who never cared about this art in the first place. And never will. This is the version of the game that will be made available going forth. And the inevitable proper remake of the game will absolutely suffer for this. The only reason to remake anything is if you can make it better. This is not it. Fuck everyone responsible for this. That's all I had for today. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you all in the next one.